Well, decided to put on a little kids camp and see how many kids we could get into the community of CrossFit. I work with a lot of kids in the schools. A lot of parents were asking what I could do for a summer program that would entertain their kids. And I think we were able to achieve a lot more than just entertain their kids. I set the goal of the camp to be based on CrossFit movements, about nutrition, about an academic way they can understand studying and how it helps after post-workouts, and also creating community. What are the two ways we can get organized? Everybody bring your arms up. Shoulders back. Turn your palms up. Hands down at the side, right? Pulling our shoulders back. We're getting organized in our shoulders. So whenever we're standing, we're practicing good posture, right? We're getting organized in our shoulders, right? We're training our shoulders to be back, to stay back, okay? It's important. When we sit down to do homework at our desk, gotta do that, right? Keep our shoulders back.
The point of this camp is probably like tenfold. There's so much to it. It's, you know, to get a group of kids together, to learn about community, to learn about health and fitness, each of which is essential for a good life, and then also to, you know, make friends, have fun, but kind of learn what it takes and the skills that they'll use for the rest of their lives to live healthy, make good choices. And more importantly, I think most importantly, with the goal of this camp is to kind of for them to see that there's so much out there that's bigger than they are. And, you know, seeing kids that don't have water when they're, if you can see behind, they're out there playing in a lake and having so much fun and you know, the things that they take for granted every day. That they realize that there's kids in the world that don't have that, and now they're all coming together and them seeing them brainstorm on ways that they can save these other kids. You know, one kid came up to me today and he goes, "I already have $40 I'm going to give, and you know, I'm going to donate my clothes, I'm going to donate my toys," and they're so eager and so excited to help, and that's been really inspiring to see. And I think it's good for them to realize that there's more out there, you know, more than just Roseburg, Oregon. All these kids haven't been outside of the city.
I want you to keep it flag pulled while I show you the movement. Now we're gonna work on the press, okay? The strict press. We're just gonna press, we're gonna pretend like this is really heavy, and we're gonna push it up overhead. Initially, we had our feet out here. Now I want you to put your hands on your hips, right on your hips, and I want you to put your feet right under your hands. There you go. Feet right under your hands. Are we all there? Now just jump up and down. Everyone jump. And land. Okay, that's where your feet are always going to land, right under your hips, okay? And I want you to put it up on your shoulders. So hold it out in front of you like this, and then bring it back and set it on your shoulders. So you want to, there you go, point your fingers at me, just like that. There you go.
If we teach kids what it's like to be in a community and how we want to live, then they'll grow up and be that model, hopefully. And by getting them into a program like this, I think that we're doing just that. CrossFit has spawned a whole new kind of thinking. You know, it's not just going to the gym and getting fit. It's about how we can better ourselves in many different ways. And if we're community-minded, we look after the people in our community. We want to see everybody grow and succeed and push themselves. So the goal of the camp was really to create that within these children and give them something to look forward to in their life and goals to shoot forward.
So what is community to you? Okay, so you can start drawing and writing and brainstorming what your community is. And then eventually we're going to decide how we want to use our community to raise money to get what? Water, right, for those people who don't have it.
In CrossFit, right, it's about bettering each person, not just physically, but emotionally, kind of empowering people. And I think there's no better demographic that we can empower than kids, because, you know, they are our future. These are going to be future affiliate owners, future CrossFitters, just future citizens of the world, basically. And for them to have the skills and the knowledge to go out and help others and realize that there's more than just themselves. And people have such a tendency to be so kind of self-involved, and something like this, CrossFit, you know, if you're in there doing a workout, with your community, you're realizing kind of where you can push yourself. You're realizing that there's more than whatever crap you dealt with during the day. You know, you can come to the gym and you can release that. And it's kind of the same, just that realization that there's so much more to life and to the world than maybe the one little problem that you're suffering from that day or whatever the case may be. And realizing that they can, you know, in a workout, a kid can realize, wow, I can do this. Sense of empowerment, and that same thing can go with this whole sense of community and realizing that one little choice they make or one little gift they give or one little, you know, fundraiser they throw can really make a difference for someone else.
Not we're selling something like but games mm-hmm. or like kid Olympics kind of thing, and then if they would pay to come in it, and then if they won we could have a prize, so that would motivate them to come, and then right before it we could play like the movie that we watched so they would know why they're doing it.
Well, heard about some new initiatives in CrossFit and creating water for children around the globe, specifically actually in Kenya, and thought that would be a great project. Here in the Pacific Northwest, we're typically don't have any water droughts. We don't have any issues with water. You can see the lake down there the kids enjoying now, but wanted them to get a sense of what's out there in the world. And create something that's bigger than themselves, something that they could give back to and be a part of. So we presented the idea to them and showed them a series of videos, and they absolutely loved the idea of helping children around in Kenya specifically.
If they can help with Coins for Kenya. And then I wrote some more ideas on the back, like what we could do. Like we could have little donation boxes around and then have people with posters and stuff to, I don't know, just advertise better. Like people signed on the street to advertise for businesses.
Does somebody want to tell us what they think of community? Anybody? About Ellie?
I think that it's the people you're around a lot, and like there can be different communities. Like I have a couple, like people at school and the people at church, people, you know, that are dropping in all the time.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So people that are in your community are people that have common interests that you have, right? So they're people that you meet every day, people that you go play with, right? At the school, kids that are in your class, parents that go to the CrossFit gym, right? We're all kind of a part of the same community. We all have the same ideas and goals, right? We want to be healthy. We want to eat healthy. And maybe some of us go to church together. So that is really what our community is, right? So we're all like-minded. So with the goal of talking about community this week, I wanted to come up with a project that we could all get involved in. And as our CrossFit Kids Camp, creating a community where we could have a common goal to doing something and creating something that's bigger than just the camp here itself.